Hey guys, National Day is coming soon, and to mark the occasion, I'm wearing the unofficial Singapore uniform, the Uniqlo oversized t-shirt. Anyway, today's topic will be every Singaporean's favorite, the BTO and the new PLH scheme. So conventional wisdom and a lot of people out there are advocating that HDB is a depreciating asset. You must sell as soon as possible. You shouldn't hold for too long because the value will decline over time due to lease decay. But like any new policy, there will definitely be new opportunities for us to tap into. And with the implementation of the new PLH scheme, I feel that yes, conventional wisdom still holds true to a large extent because HDB in general do not perform well compared to private properties. But there are certain areas which I think is worthwhile to take a deeper look at. But before that, let's try to understand what are some of the new rules that PLH flats have that will impact your resale prices. I'm very sure you guys would have known by now that unlike the usual 5-year MOP for HDB flats, PLH flats have a 10-year MOP period. This means that you can't sell or rent out the flat for a decade. There is also the subsidy clawback, meaning to say that in the future after you MOP, the government mandate that you have to pay back a certain percentage of the sales price. So if you look at the latest BTO launches in June 2024, so for the ones at Tanjong Rhu and the one at Holland, the subsidy recovery rate is 9%. Means you sell 1 million, 90,000 goes back to the government. So next, for the normal BTO flats, the couple buying can be both PRs. But for this new scheme, you must have at least one Singapore citizen as the applicant. This also applies to the next buyers who are buying the PLH flat as well. So this will effectively remove a certain group from buying already. So the rules I've just mentioned are, you know, pretty painful, but the next rule is what I feel will be the needle mover in really trying to curb the increase in HDB prices. For the normal resale flat, there is no income ceiling for the next buyer to come and purchase your flat. But for the prime and plus flats, there is an income ceiling of $14,000. So how much people earn is a direct reflection of the purchasing power they have for the property. For a couple having a combined salary of $14,000 and taking a bank loan, let's take a look at the numbers here. Maximum loan you can take is about 795K. So the flat you can afford based on the maximum 75% LTV and 25-year loan tenor is about 1.06 million. So I feel that it is very likely for the resale prices to hover around this $1 million range in future. Anything above this price, the buyer wouldn't be able to take the full loan and have to pay COV to purchase the unit. Of course, there are people who have the financial muscle to do so, but I think most of us couldn't and wouldn't do so lah. So how would this affect the normal HDB flat in the same area that is not classified as prime or plus? I just want to caveat, this is just my prediction because the first batch of PLH flat will MOP only about 15 years later, and then we start to see them in the resale market. Only time would tell. Logically, properties with longer lease should cost more than the surrounding older resale with shorter lease. And following this logic, the PLH flats will be newer, so technically should cost more, right? But I feel that with so many government restrictions, buyers who are priced out of the private market but earn above $14,000 have no choice but to purchase the normal HDB flats. Because without the income ceiling, buyers of the normal HDB flats in prime locations can take a higher loan, potentially supporting the higher resale prices. So I feel that the older resale flats in prime areas might be able to hold their value well thanks to this new policy. I say again, hold value well, not huge capital gains. If you want a huge capital gain from it, probably not happening. And I also just want to add one more layer to this. If you notice, over the past few years, HDB has also stopped offering 5-room flats in the popular estates or near MRT stations, which going forward will be the prime and plus type of flats. That means that the biggest flats that they are offering to the buyers are 4-room flats. So no more supply of 5-room flats in these locations going forward, making the existing ones super rare. So where do you think the price will head towards? Just take a look at this article that came out a few days ago. Record price of a 5-room HDB flat at Margaret Drive. I don't think this will be a one-off transaction in a few years' time lah. Of course, there are other considerations such as the super old HDBs and the standard restrictions such as how much CPF OA you can use and how much loan you can take, especially when the remaining lease of the flat cannot cover the youngest buyer until 95 years old. And all these restrictions will start to kick in, affordability drops, and the pool of buyers start to shrink. So if you are considering getting a PLH flat, I really hope you think through it first. I'm not here to say you shouldn't buy, but just need to be aware of the blind spots before pulling the trigger. Because you'll be tied down easily 14 to 15 years. But by all means, if you really love the location, go for it. Ultimately, I just want to reiterate that HDB is not a tool meant for investment. HDB's mission is to provide affordable homes for Singaporeans. And the purpose of my video here is to try to predict what kind of HDB flats might hold better value over time. And this can be quite contrarian to what a lot of people out there are advocating. So if you are still confused or sitting on the fence and would like to have a one-to-one consultation session with me to run through your property options, just drop me a WhatsApp text here and I'll be more than happy to help. So with that, this is the end of the video, and let me know in the comments below if you have a different viewpoint. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more real estate insights. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.